It is a good maxim with which to go into a world of danger, a good maxim to go to sea with, a good maxim in a storm, a good maxim when in danger on the land, a good maxim when we are sick, a good maxim when we think of death and the judgment. And that maxim is this: what time I am afraid, I will trust in thee. This is a quote coming to you from Barnes Notes. In this broadcast, we are continuing the theme of resolutions in our new series entitled In the Beginning Was the Word. In this particular broadcast, we will deal with resolution number 4, as found in Psalm 56:3, which says, "What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee." And we have entitled this resolution, "No Fair Weather Trust." Psalm 56:3 says, this is David speaking, "What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee." What he was actually saying here was, what day I am afraid, the day I am afraid, the day when I am afraid. Now notice David didn't hesitate to admit that there were times when he was afraid. He saw himself to be in danger, and so he had apprehensions as a result. He feared, but he did not let fear control him or paralyze him. He did not let fear fill the whole area of his mind. Now, I want to tell you this at this point. Believers, just like David, every believer will have his or her time of fear, times of fear. Believers will have their times of fear. Now, I know some will recoil on that because the faith teaching, some of it has gone to such an extreme to the point of error where you have people nowadays who cannot be real, cannot be honest, would not dare to ask somebody, could you please pray for me? Because I'm under attack. I'm having all these fears come against me. They don't want to do that lest they be judged of being unspiritual or worse your faith. And how could you be given into fears? When we're saying that believers will have their times of fear. And God forbid if a pastor would admit, I'm going through times right now where I'm undergoing fears. I'm facing great fears. Or a pastor, a bishop, a superintendent, a leader. God forbid. Because then people would criticize and judge and say, well, you're not spiritual. That is so wrong. Are you greater than David? David said, what time? I am afraid. Believers will have their times of fear. We have enemies. There are many, lively and strong, and these enemies will come against us with such fear to paralyze us. Not only that, but as believers, we will face seasons when fear will be awakened. You may know, maybe you experienced this yourself, where there was a time when everything was going so well. The family was in good health. You were prospering. Things couldn't have been better. The children were all serving the Lord. And then all of a sudden, you got hit with this season where fear became awakened. And I'm talking about a season where maybe you faced domestic trials or bereaving providences. And these are some of the heaviest of trials, when a loved one was just suddenly taken away to be with Jesus, or you face personal affliction or the prospect of death, and all of a sudden this new season hit you and fear came alive, fear was awakened. And then there are others who have had to encounter disasters, losses, partings, disappointments, once again, sicknesses and death that came at an unexpected moment. And, you know, it comes sooner or later. Many times it comes sooner rather than later. And people have faced this, and fear has awakened, come alive. You know, when David said, "What time I am afraid," maybe he should have said, "What times I was afraid, what times I am afraid." I'm just being facetious here, but the times are many, is what I'm trying to get across. The times for David were many when he was afraid, and the times for the believer will be many. There's the fear for tomorrow. There are many right now that are struggling. They're bowed down with anxiety, worry, care, the restlessness of doubt. There are others who are facing the fact of death, maybe their death or another, a loved one's death, or the destiny of their future life, wondering, what, you know, will I have a job next January? How's my family going to survive? What am I going to do after I finish school? And all these questions, what's my destiny for the future? Fears are common to all men at one time or another. It doesn't matter what title you wear, what position you have. Fears are common to all men, to all men. And we must understand that. But what happens is, there are improper and ineffective means of removing fear that's often resorted to. And I'm talking about in the church, among so-called believers or believers. There are people that try to remove fear through alcohol, through pills, through narcotics, through drugs, through relationships, through busyness, through getting involved in all kinds of activities, trying to just drown out the voice of fear. But here we see David suggests a true and effectual method of removing fear. He said, "What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee." What David was saying here is, when I have the greater cause of fear, I will rely upon God's providence and promise for my deliverance. When the day comes that I feel fear stealing over me, by an act of my will, I will put my trust in God. I will trust in God. I'm going to trust in you, Lord. You're the one I turn to in trouble. I will put my trust and my confidence in the Lord. And David is telling us here, this is the best antidote against fears. Put your trust and confidence in the Lord, who is unchangeable in his love. It's in him that you have everlasting strength. He is faithful and true to every word of promise. I will trust in thee. That word trust signifies literally to cling to or hold fast to something. It expresses the notion of a good, tight grip. But for you to cling to the Lord's hand, you have to make sure that your hand is at first empty. You can have solutions in your hand. You're trying to fix the problem. You're trying to solve the problem, come up with the answers. You're trying to help God. No, you have to empty your hand before you can cling to his. Listen to what Matthew Henry said. There are some times which are, in a special manner, times of fear with God's people. In those times, it is their duty and interest to trust in God as their God, and to know in whom they have trusted. This will fix the heart and keep it in peace. In seasons that come your way that seem to awaken fear, David's saying, trust in God. Have a firm hold of God. Trust in God. Trust in his wisdom, his love, his fatherly care, his plans, his purposes. David saying, get more light What does he mean by that? Well, the Bible says, the entrance of thy word giveth light. Dig into the word, and then you will exercise more trust. Realize that God is behind all events. He's before all contingencies. He's before all those crises, dilemmas. He goes before you today. He's above the clouds, and he's below the waters. Now, nature or the world all around, they have a message. They're constantly pumping it out. Be afraid, be afraid, be afraid. Everywhere you look, that's what the world's saying. Be afraid, be afraid, be afraid. And then there are those who try to oppose that fear by coming up with this groundless confidence, this foolish confidence, if you will. And they try to see if the facts could be altered by resolving not to think about them. You know, maybe if I ignore this, it will go away. Well, it's madness to think that you could ignore fear or the cause of it. And it's also madness to go around thinking that you could just repeat, you know, by an act of your will, you'll just go around saying, I will not be afraid. I will not be afraid. I will not be afraid. Really, there's no power in that because you're not connected to any power there. Self-will is no power. Listen to what David said. He said, I will trust and not be afraid. There's a difference in what he said. I will trust and not be afraid. Now, no doubt about it, it's not an easy matter to fix your eyes on God because you have threatening enemies within arm's length that are compelling your gaze. They're constantly trying to get your gaze. Look at us. Look at the circumstances. Look at the problems. Look at the conditions. They're constantly after you to look at them, look at what they're doing, rather than looking at the Lord. But this is where your will comes in. You have to have a fixed resolve. Like David said, I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. You have to be bravely resolved. This is no fair weather trust here. And it's not a product of outward circumstances, but it's of a fixed resolve that I am going to keep my focus on Jesus. Listen to what the biblical illustrator said. True faith, by a mighty effort of the will, fixes its gaze on the divine helper, and there finds it possible and wise to lose its fears. That's how you lose your fears, by gazing on your divine helper, on the Lord Jesus. The Family Bible Note said, trust in God is the grand support in adversity and is one of the things which distinguish the righteous from the wicked. The wicked are not looking to Jesus. They're looking to everything but him. But the righteous keep their focus on Jesus. That's the difference. That's the difference. Well, you may ask, what does it mean to put your trust in God? What is it? What? How do I put my trust in God? Well, you guard your heart. You keep your heart from desponding or sinking down under any fears. You comfort yourself in God and you expect deliverance from him. What is there in God that you ought to put your trust in? You can put your trust in his word, in his promises, his properties, his power, his wisdom, his all-sufficiency. He has so much, his mercy, his grace. You can put your trust in him. Why should you in your fears put your trust in God? Because there is none else that can secure you from your fears. Oh, I want you to hear that today. There is nobody else, none else, that can secure you from your fears but the Lord Jesus Christ. He's the only one that can remove the thing feared or subdue the fear of the thing. He's the only one. Now this is, we're not calling for a fair weather trust here or a product of your outward circumstances. No, you must understand that Jesus is your one and only answer. When you have that understanding, then you will have a fixed resolve. And you will be able to say like David, what time I am afraid, I will trust in thee. Our time is up for today's broadcast, but I'm asking you to stay tuned for our next teaching as we continue our study of resolutions as found in the book of Psalms. This is Connie Giordano with Walking in Truth Ministry, praying that you will face every challenge you meet in the upcoming days with supernatural faith because you are truly trusting in God.